So let's open a point list from a TXT file in LandSurvey app, AgroSurvey Wizard, so that you can start to stake out those points. First, we need to know what is a point list. A point list is a list of points that you can see in this TXT file. In this TXT file, there are different columns, like a point number, the X coordinate, the Y coordinate, the Z coordinate, and the column of a description. This description can be a code or a layer name. In case of AppGloss Survey Wizard, it is a layer name. So we are in AppGloss Survey Wizard now, and we click on the Files menu, and then we click Open. We don't want to save any current survey information. So then we go and select the folder where the TXT file is in, and we click on Select. Then we need to select the list with the points in the TXT file. And then we click OK. The points are loaded in a list, and now you see the settings screen of the TXT file. You can change the country and the coordinate system if you want, but in my case it's alright. You can change the scale factor, but also here one is fine, and then you select the format of the TXT file. In my case it's point number X, Y, Z and layer name, and after selecting the right file format for the TXT file, you click OK, and as you can see the points got loaded in AppGloss Survey Wizard. There is a possibility that the columns in your TXT file are not the same as in the methods in AppGloss Survey Wizard. So then we have to do it a bit different. So now we will open another TXT file. So we go to the Files menu and click on Open. We don't want to save the current survey information, so we click No. And then we select the folder again. For this example, I will choose the same TXT file and click OK. We imagine that the file format is not in the list, so we select Custom. And here you see another settings screen for the TXT file, and you can again change the country, the ellipsoid, and the coordinate reference system. The multiplication factor is 1, and then we have to change the separator sign. In our case it's a space, and then you can change the decimal sign, but it's a point. And now the TXT file looks like the columns are separated well, so we can now select the different columns. For the point number we select column 1, then for the X we select column 2, then for the Y we select column 3, and then for the Z we select column 4, and then for the layer name we select column 5. And then we click on the OK button. And again, the points are loaded now in AppGloss Survey Wizard. That's how you open a point list in a TXT file in AppGloss Survey Wizard. If you want to know more about AppGloss Survey Wizard, check out this video.